Right in the heart of Chinatown, there's one spot that's got its finger on the pulse of edginess. They're merging an urban feel with fusion dishes along with traditional culinary and decor elements. Get ready to go for the gold at Rice and Gold.
Rice and Gold 这家餐厅的地址也很有趣，它背对的呢就是曼哈顿大桥，然后两边的夹角呢是 Canal 和 Bowery，是不是听起来就非常 Chinatown 的感觉？我曾经采访过 Dale，但他这家新店呢，我还是真是没有尝过。看到所有的这些装饰以及他所在的地理位置，我已经对他的食物充满了兴趣了，我要去尝尝。
Rice and Gold is located in the Bowery Hotel, intersecting Chinatown and the Lower East Side. It was opened by popular chef Dale Talde, who's a national restaurateur and finalist on the hit show Top Chef. Dale was born into a Filipino family in Chicago and graduated from the Culinary Institute of America. Now he's taking a risk in the Chinese epicenter of Manhattan, one meal at a time.
Rice and Gold 比我想象的其实要大很多，它整个空间很宽敞，就比平时我们去的一些中餐厅或者是 Asian Fusion 的餐厅呢要大上很多。有两个很有意思的地方，一个是我背后，就是它的这个厨房是整个是比较开放的空间。通常呢，我们去这些中餐馆的时候呢，都是家庭氛围比较浓、比较 intimate， 就是更温暖一些。在这里呢，就是感觉空间很大，而且开放性厨房，你都可以看到这些厨师他们在干什么。另外一个我觉得很有意思，就是在这个开放性厨房上面有两排。 招财猫，两排，大大小小，琳琅满目的招财猫。
Combining the iconic Chinese lucky cat with New York graffiti is quite the mashup. It's not just happening in the decor, though. Check out the food. Graffiti is something that you normally see in the subway or in Bushwick or Williamsburg or Lower Manhattan, but now it's in the restaurant space. You can see behind me that there is a whole New York scene painted out here from street signs and cups of coffee to Chinese tags and Chinese newspapers. I think this is super cool. It gives it a really fun urban feel in this restaurant. And I like it because it feels like I'm dining with all of the New York community. There's so many different individuals on this wall over here, whether they're American, Asian, European. It's got a little bit of everything, so I'm a happy camper. Let's take a look at their signature dishes, starting with their grilled lobster. When you hit the streets of Chinatown, you won't miss advertisements for this traditional dish. However, Rice and Gold is giving this Chinese favorite a savory makeover.
So this one is a tamarind brown butter sauce. So it gets a little bit of nuttiness from the brown butter and a little bit of a sourness from the tamarind sauce.
Tamarind is an ingredient used in Southeast Asian cooking and can be found in favorites like Tom Yum Gung soup. At Rice and Gold, they mix it into a brown butter sauce, giving it a richer and nuttier flavor. To make this dish, the lobster is grilled on the oven. Then it's coated with the tamarind brown butter sauce and sprinkled with finely chopped green onions. The complexity of the flavors combined with the simplicity of the preparation are sure to wow us.
It's the first time we see a grilled lobster in an Asian-flavored, Asian-style restaurant. It's the first time.
This is a first. But I don't hate it.
Okay, I know this is sushi rice.
And then we get a piece of our...
Do we? Okay.
The piece of the lobster. And...
This is my favorite. And when I eat it, I feel like I can taste the smokiness from the griller and also the fruity taste from the tamarind, and oh, so buttery.
It's so, so buttery and delicious, oh. Ma'am.
And I love the invention of combining the sushi rice and seaweed. Seaweed can be very crispy, salty, and sushi rice is very chewy, give you the sweetness of the rice. It's such a good combination.
It's a really good combination.
I've never tasted anything like this before.
I haven't either.
From one Southeast Asian dish to the next, we're on to the papaya salad. But this isn't your typical salad.
We're gonna take the papaya and the sweet potato and dust it with flour so that the dredge can stick to it. And next, we're gonna start the plating. A little touch of salt. Sort of tamarind chili sauce.
For a Rice and Gold spin, the salad is dressed with tamarind chili sauce. The flavor and richness is toned down with fresh watermelon.
And then fresh cut watermelon.
It's mixed together with fried and fresh papaya and fried sweet potatoes. It's quite the combination for a salad.
On top. And next, comes the crispy papaya.
Hi, that's good. I love the combination of the spicy sauce and the sweet and refreshing watermelon.
I'm refreshing myself now. You have to have fresh watermelon in this, or it would be too sour.
And too unhealthy.
I love it.
I do too.
We explored the Vietnamese pho soup dumplings.
What is this inside?
That is phenomenal.
It's pho?
It seems like pork to me. And it's got a very peppery taste to it. But that is definitely pho broth.
It reminds me of xiaolongbao, but it's very different. And the broth is not as much as they put in the xiaolongbao. It's salty and savory.
And there's a Vietnamese added touch here because of the chili peppers that are placed on top.
I mean, everything in a pho bowl is in this bowl here. We can see there's bean sprout and cilantro, basil, and also a little bit chili on top.
So these
give you a kick.
These are very good to have when you're chilling, when you've been outside for way too long.
Tian and I are no strangers to oysters, but this is a totally new creation. We're excited to see where these flavors take us.
When I see it, I'm like, it's just regular oyster. You go to an oyster bar, but then... Ta-da.
But then below, something was hiding under there.
Now that's a surprise. It's served with kimchi fried rice.
那在韩国呢，其实韩国人吃的东西大部分很多都是有海鲜在里面。我们吃过这个海鲜豆腐汤什么的，但是呢，在韩国他们其实是非常盛产牡蛎，尤其是在统一那个地方，这种有韩国的泡菜和韩国很新鲜的海鲜组成的饭。那这个就是一个非常典型的例子。
Which also will make it much lighter, like if it's a lot of meat, it'll be very heavy, but this is seafood and veggie tables.
I think so. Okay, I'm gonna have my bite.
Do it.
It is super, super good.
Wow.
The traditional dim sum is getting some competition. Their lobster and scallop har gow combines the past, present, and future of Chinese cooking.
I like this one.
Yeah.
It feels like you're eating a bowl with really good Italian squid ink pasta and with good stuffing inside. I can taste lobster, a little bit scallop. It's like a seafood inside of a dumpling.
I was not expecting it to be as spicy as it is. It's definitely very hot. I thought the only kick would be from the chili oil, but there's a lot of spice happening in there as well.
And I do like the broth here, the sauce or the broth, whatever you call it.
Mm-hmm.
You can taste a very strong flavor of the crab.
You know what it kind of reminds me of? A little bit of like clam chowder.
Outside of the dumpling, it's very chewy. It's a really good dumpling wrap.
Good dumpling. None of that soggy stuff.
I give it a 10. This is the one that I would go to social media and recommend.
Worse stuff, but of course we have room for more. We finish off with a deluxe spin on a Filipino classic.
This is a very traditional Filipino dish, but with a refined version.
It looks like there's a bunch of different ingredients in here too, like we have a quail egg. I love these little guys, they're so cute. Mm-hmm. Quail egg, we have trout roe, as well as
some crab meat. it's a homemade dish. Mm. I think you can compare it to like Chinese noodles, Chinese beef noodle.
I was thinking dan mian. That's exactly what I thought of when I saw this. The same thick noodles, that brothy sauce. Mmm. Wow. It's kind of like an Asian pasta carbonara, a little bit.
Oh.
Like a very creamy sauce.
Mmm. This is definitely lighter than I imagined with all the roux here. And I think it's definitely a really good suggestion, Danny, thank you, to use lemon in it.
Mmm. Because it cuts it. Like, it's not over the top creamy, but it needs something to balance it out, something acidic.
Do you think rice and gold made the gold standard? It seems that no detail has been left out, from the eclectic interior to the experimental food. Through Chef Dale's dishes, you can see the evolution of Asian food and the delicious direction that it's heading in.